Solve the equation, check the answer. 4n is equal to 48. So we see that the variable term, 4n, is by itself, and so we only need to isolate the variable. Right now it's being multiplied by 4, so we will divide by 4 both sides of the equation. This yields n is equal to 12. Let's check our work through substitution. 4 times 12, is this equal to 48? And yes, it is. So n equals 12 is our solution. Exercise B. Negative 6w is equal to 81. Again, we see that the variable term is isolated, and so we now just need to isolate the variable itself. We will divide through both sides of the equation by negative 6. This isolates the w, and 81 over negative 6 will be a negative, and we can reduce that fraction by a factor of 3 to 27 over 2. Let's check our work. Is negative 6 times negative 27 over 2 equal to 81? Well, a negative times a negative is positive, and we can reduce between the 6 and the 2, leaving a factor of 3, and 3 times 27 is 81. So 81 equals 81, that checks out. So w equals negative 27 halves. Exercise C, we have the opposite of A is 24. So we can think of this as opposite of A or negative A, however you want to look at it, but it helps maybe to see it written like that negative or that opposite is negative 1 times A is equal to 24. We rarely write it like that, but it's helpful to see it like that the first couple of times so you understand how to proceed with this equation. Again, I see the variable term isolated, and so now I will isolate the variable through division. I will divide both sides of the equation by negative 1. This will isolate the a, and 24 divided by negative 1 is negative 24. Let's check our work. Is the opposite of negative 24 equal to 24? And yes, it is. 24 is 24. So the solution is A equals negative 24.